Hello and welcome back to the Flat Chat. It's me, Callum, here. I'm here with Heggy. And we've just watched a very exciting match of football. Maybe some with the score we didn't expect.
Yep.
But of course, if you're not sure what we're talking about yet, Liverpool, Man City. And Liverpool did win. 1-0. A lot of people weren't expecting this. Do you want to take us away with that, Heggy, and just talk about what just happened in this game?
It was absolute chaos.
Yeah.
From start to finish. We did just watch the two best teams in the Premier League. I think the table does lie sometimes.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't think it's telling the truth when it comes to Liverpool, because the way they played today was unbelievable. They nullified City.
Mm-hmm.
When no one's been able to do that all season. I can't remember the last time they scored zero goals in the Premier League. They did midweek against Copenhagen, of course.
Man sent off as well.
Yeah, but no, they deserved the win. But do you think Pep will be upset that his team's not created more chances in this one?
Perhaps, but I think a big part of that is down to Liverpool. The way they dropped in deep. They went with the 4-4-2 again. I think Salah was up top. And then they would just play the long ball. Very different to what Liverpool have done over the years. It's a lot more direct.
Yeah.
Whereas beforehand, they were able to have a three-prong attack and you know counter-attack in a different way. I think it's a real danger. Man City had to be a bit more wary of that.
Yeah.
Not get as many bodies forward. But City probably will. Pep Guardiola will be a little bit annoyed about the fact that his team just didn't. They didn't create any real clear cut chances. Off the top of my head, I can think there was the Haaland one. Of course,
but the header.
I think Alisson deserves a bit of credit for that.
Yeah.
The way he's positioned himself for it. And you can't really ask for much more than from Haaland in that situation. But there wasn't too many big clear cut chances for City. And
no.
And as I said, maybe you do credit Liverpool a bit more for that.
I do think, however, City are still a better team than Liverpool, but it didn't show today. They kept the ball, City. They're just the best team in the world at that currently.
Mm-hmm.
But as you said, they didn't create clear-cut chances,
no. Which
you need to do, especially when you've got Haaland.
Yeah,
you know
that it's the game. It is the game plan. I think you even mentioned it during the game when we were watching it. How they look like they're constantly just trying to find Haaland in the box.
Yeah.
And just he kept on hanging on to Virgil van Dijk as well, which I thought was a bit strange. I think that was more when the ball was out in the left hand side, he would move over to onto van Dijk for some reason. Assuming the ball is going to come in deep into the box, the back post.
Yeah.
But I don't. It was just such an exciting game to watch, but
I was worried for Liverpool before this game started, based on the lineups. I was not confident for them when
Milner.
I saw Joe Gomez and Milner as the right side on the defence, especially with the way Foden's been playing.
Yeah.
Foden did have a good game, but Gomez did his job. Foden did have the better of Milner, but that's expected because Milner's like 40 years old. But
Gomez, I think Gary Neville gave him the man of the match.
Yeah.
He's probably was up there with one of the best players for Liverpool today. He did everything he was meant to do.
Definitely. And I was surprised with City's lineup as well, if I'm being completely honest.
How so?
The way they set up, because De Bruyne played in that right hand side. It was he was playing right mid, right wing.
Yeah, it's where we've seen actually Bernardo Silva play quite a lot.
Bernardo Silva played deep in the midfield.
Yeah.
But I don't know. Pep's clearly saw something and thought he has to change his team up to set up against Liverpool at Anfield, but it just didn't work.
Do you think he's tinkered too much?
I think he has, yeah.
It's similar to games in the past, such as, off the top of my head, thinking the game against Chelsea in the Champions League final, where he overthought too much and he just didn't go with his game plan. I think sometimes he needs to realise, Pep, you've got the best team probably in the world.
Play to your strengths.
Yeah, play to your strengths. And if they can deal with it, that you change something during the game.
Yeah.
I don't think you set up the game the way he did. I think if it's not going your way, that's when you make changes as the game goes.
Yeah.
That's what a good manager does. And that here's me giving tips to Pep, but
but they've got the best,
something he will think about.
They've got the best player in the league and they didn't play him in his proper position.
Yeah,
it just doesn't make sense to me.
Yeah.
But I'm not a professional football manager, you know.
We're just gonna critique them.
Yeah.
On to another football manager though, opposition manager, Jurgen Klopp was getting feisty on the touchline, wasn't he?
Yeah.
Obviously, to the point where he got a red card.
Well, they did jump into the assistant's face.
To be fair, it was quite clearly a foul. Yeah. I don't know how no one's given it. But to be act the way he has, we love to see it. Yeah, we love to see it, but he deserves obviously to get something for that.
He's too emotional. He has a bit of a child. We all know that. He just acts like a child. So
he's just great TV. I can't fault him for it. I think it's great. You'd love to see Antonio Conte doing that. You'd love to see a Jose Mourinho doing that. I think it's just a lot of people don't like Jurgen Klopp because of some of the things he says in his press conferences and
his excuses.
He has
an excuse merchant.
Oh, he is, yeah. I'm a fellow excuse merchant. I can definitely tell one when I see one.
But do you think Anthony Taylor then today? I know we said that decision was wrong, but do you think he kept control of the game?
Oh, yeah. No, well, to be honest, he didn't really keep control of the game. Like, the game wasn't clean.
Yeah.
But he gave us, with the way he refed the game, gave us such an exciting football match. And I'm very happy and pleased that he did referee the game the way he did. Because that was just, it was end to end. It was tackles flying in. It was handbags. It's everything you want to see, especially in a game with these two teams. As you said at the start about these two probably being the best two teams in the Premier League. Over the last 5 years, it's definitely shown. And today, it definitely showed that there was two class teams going up against each other with two very different styles.
Yeah.
So
it was the Liverpool of old today.
It was, yeah.
This was the first game this season I've watched them, other than midweek, but we won't talk about that.
Oh, yeah.
Where you could say they played their game plan perfectly against a big opponent.
Mm-hmm.
They played Arsenal last week, looked poor.
To be frank, Mikel Arteta's game plan went to plan.
Yeah,
Klopp's didn't, and that's you're spot on there. We'll talk about a few players. We've obviously mentioned a few already, but we'll talk about who you think were the best players for each side.
Right, we'll start with City.
With City,
we have to start at the back with Ederson.
Ederson made an excellent save. They didn't get the corner for it, but that save for the first one in Salah from Salah was world class. It was very reminiscent of Casillas' save against Holland. Was it Holland?
Spain. In the World Cup?
Yeah. Aye.
If this game finished 0-0, he would have been my man of the match.
Mm.
But the goal went in. He had no chance with the goal. It was a 1-on-1. You don't expect him to save it. He'd already saved a 1-on-1 earlier. But Ederson definitely stand out for me for City.
From that, I think of the rest of the team, everyone kind of, there was no one that was bad. There's no other standouts, though, I would say.
There was a bad player, Cancelo.
Well, I forgot about him. Cancelo, that's probably the worst game I've seen. I've completely forgot about him. It's just you don't expect to say that.
Yeah.
Because of how good Cancelo has been for the last, 18 months, I'd say. He's been world class.
It was bad to his standards.
Yeah, for the goal, it was abysmal. It was just a horrible mistake.
Yeah. And at the end of the game as well, he kicked the ball out when they were running attack.
Yeah, no.
It didn't have a game. Oh, good game.
Yeah. And other than that, though, would you say everyone else kind of just did what you'd expect? Haaland obviously didn't score, so that's something we didn't expect.
I think the only other player you can give praise to is Foden. He looked very dangerous every time he had the ball.
He was against Milner, though, wasn't he?
Yeah.
But he was good.
Foden wants to drive at opponents, and that's what you want to see from young players, because young players a lot of the time it's like a deer in the headlights and turn back, pass, but Foden doesn't. It just drives forward. It's really good to watch.
He's a top talent, and he'll go on to do some special things in football, I think. Already has. On to Liverpool, though. We obviously mentioned about Joe Gomez. He was really good stepping in for, Matip and Kanate.
Yep. Joe Gomez has had a good season. Even at right back, I think he's looked decent. He looks good defensively.
He's
not good at driving forward.
Or playing ball. There's even passes where it's like, what are you doing? He's just overhit passes. Yeah. He's not good on the ball.
But he's a centre-back, we need to remember.
Yeah.
So,
and he played centre-back today. But other than that, Van Dijk probably played quite well.
Yep.
Dealt with Haaland when he needed to. The rest of the back four and Alisson, I think they just did their job. But you've got to talk about, as a defensive unit, they were excellent dealing with Man City.
Yeah. We'll get to Alisson in a bit with one of the other talking points in the game.
But who else, before we get to that, who else would you say was...
Salah, obviously, got the goal.
Yeah. I think he's getting back to his best, isn't he? Yeah. I think he's a bit of confidence was given to him during the week by Rangers, obviously.
Yeah.
And that's definitely spurred him on here, because he was a real threat. He was kind of playing more through the middle today.
Yeah.
But, wow.
A player as well. Oh. Went off injured.
Jota
ran his socks off.
He was really good. Really, 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 really good. And he's, I think he's, I might have pulled a hamstring. I'm not too sure.
Yeah, that's what they said in commentary, but...
It is what they said. I really, for their sake, I really hope not, because they've got injury problems already with Diaz out. I know Trent did come on, but yeah, serious issues there for injuries. And yeah, hopefully he's all right for his sake and Liverpool's sake, of course. Yeah. I think Firmino actually was okay as well, linking up the play when he was on the pitch.
Firmino's had a right turn of form, hasn't he?
Definitely has, yeah. Someone again, though, that I think Liverpool fans will be a bit torn on. Obviously, I'm talking about Darwin Nunez. He comes on, and it's just his decision-making. His decision-making, executing a lot of the things he does, it's just not good enough.
No.
But at that point in the game, there was several times where he gets the ball and he just drives forward with it. And it's probably exactly what you need at that point in the game.
It is.
But that's us saying that about an £85 million player.
Yeah.
He's great to come on and kill the game off up front by just driving forward. He's just...
I mean, he could have killed the game off better when he was 3-on-1.
Yeah, and played in Salah.
Yeah, decided to just shoot from, what, 25 yards?
And then there was another one as well, a better pass, better decision-making, and he finds Trent at the back post. And it's just... He might get there, and I think Liverpool fans will, a lot of them will be giving him the Timo Werner treatment at the moment and being like, well, he's making good runs and he's getting in the right places. Yeah. It's just really you saying, he's not great, but we like you because you play for Liverpool. That's really what it is. It's all fans do it. I think other than that, I don't really know what else to say about the players as such. But you want to talk about Alisson and that moment in the game?
Yeah, very fortunate. But it was a foul. Anthony Taylor got it wrong to begin with. Haaland pulled the shirt of Fabinho.
Oh, right, yeah. Oh, that was definitely...
Yeah.
That was...
But it did show Alisson to maybe not be as secure as people thought. He rushed out.
Well, he's got to do what he did. I think it's just more the fact that it's Haaland. I don't think it's anything bad on his part, really.
I don't know.
He gets his hands on the ball, and it's just because of Haaland's... I don't think that's anything, any real talking about.
Who was it that finished it? Foden?
Foden, yeah.
It was a good finish. Gomez maybe should have done better in the
Maybe Gomez should have done better. I think, Alisson's point of view, he got a bit lucky, I'd say, but I wouldn't say it was anything... I wouldn't say it's a real negative for him. I think it's just he got lucky that there was a foul on the build-up.
He did spill the ball, though. And but it's not a spill against Haaland.
I bet it's not a spill the ball, because he's because of where he is. What else can he do? He's put his hands in the ball.
He's got his
hands in the ball. It's just because it doesn't look as secure as you'd like to see when you've got, like, the keeper has possession of the ball. He's not flapped at it or anything like that. Haaland's just come steamrolling in. He's actually fallen into the ball.
Yeah.
And the ball's not in here, the ball is out there. Like, it's, I don't think there's much more he can do. And maybe Stu can give us, our friend Stu can give us more of an insight on that.
You could give praise to Alisson, though, with the pass for the goal.
Oh, of course, yeah.
He saw Sal up there. It is just terrible from Cancelo, though.
Yeah.
Let's be frank.
Yeah, so what can we now see from these two teams going forward, then?
Well, it shows that Arsenal are definitely title favourites, because City do have a chink in their armour.
But as we've said earlier on, you think these two are the best teams in the league.
I do.
And Arsenal aren't.
But I think there's too many points between Liverpool and Arsenal now. I think Arsenal will still finish above Liverpool. I think Liverpool have too many injury issues.
Mm-hmm.
I think Arsenal... grinding out results, especially today, they were abysmal.
Oh, yeah, we'll get to that. We'll get to that.
Yeah.
In a later video.
Yeah.
That's fair. Liverpool, to be fair to them, though, did claw back quite a big gap last year.
But they didn't
on Man City. Yeah. Whereas this is Arsenal.
But they didn't have 9 first team injuries.
Yeah, that's true. It's very true. I think honestly City will be fair. I think City will still go on to win the league. They did look really good in spells. Up against obviously a solid back line.
You would be really silly to bet against City.
Yeah, I think you would be. I think Arsenal can now comfortably say we probably are in a title race even 10 games into the season, but we're definitely not title favourites. So
you're second favourite.
I think we probably are. But Spurs, to be fair, they're still their level on points with City.
Spurs don't look good, though.
No, they don't, but they get results.
Yeah, but you've had one game like that. Spurs have had 6 games like that
this season. I still think Liverpool can easily finish in that top four. They'd probably finish in the top four, for sure. I mean, how far off are they off
They're 6 points behind.
6 points behind fourth. Yeah, no, I think they will finish top four if they can get their players back and fit. Diaz, obviously, we know is going to be out for a while. But yeah, I just...
Maybe the World Cup will be good for them.
Yeah, I think so. I think it will be. I think it's,
they
it's
might benefit the most from any club.
Yeah, it's going to feel like two seasons. It really is.
You might win the half-season trophy.
Oh, I'll take it. I haven't had a trophy in ages. It'll feel just like the top four trophy all over again.
Yeah.
It's a made-up trophy just for Arsenal. But no, I think we've pretty summed it up pretty well there. City, still probably favourites after this game. Going out there, they are favourites.
Yeah.
Like, as you said, you'd be stupid to bet against them for winning the league still. And I do reckon Liverpool will break into that top four at some point. Of course, Man United dropping points today. You've said Spurs haven't looked too good, still getting points. And then, of course, there's Chelsea, who are looking good.
Yeah.
And could be another one, another banker for top four. So, yeah, that has been our match review of the City-Liverpool game. Of course, we've talked about what's going to happen in the future as well. And, of course, don't forget to watch our match, our game
Prem
week.
Review.
Yeah, our Prem review, which comes out tomorrow. We'll be reviewing all the games in a longer video, talking about Arsenal playing, of course, against Leeds, Chelsea's win against Villa.
Spurs,
of course, a really impressive win against Everton. But, yeah, thank you very much for watching. If you've liked... Give it a like, leave us a comment, and don't forget to subscribe. Thank you.